Congratulations, 3-0 win. Got off to an explosive start there, didn't you?
Yeah, it sets you up for the game then when you get the early goals. Tough first half again. We were immense at times. You know, we got the goals as early as, well, the way it come about, we got them nice and early. Like you just said, it sets us up for the rest of the game in the sense of that you just got to keep a clean sheet, then you win the game. But yeah, we started out like it out on fire, so I'm very pleased.
Can I expect a reaction of any opposition in the second half? You got one, but dealt with it quite well, I thought.
Yeah, the first 10 minutes of the second half, you know, we've come out, we started a little bit slowly, you know, but I'll take into the account that to the fact that we worked really, really hard in first half. We moved the ball all over the pitch, we worked very, very hard. So it took us like, you know, we've had a little 15 minutes rest and sometimes it takes you another 10 minutes to get going. Bakehub have come out and had a little go. We've weathered the bitter storm that we sort of had. And then from then on, there was definitely only going to be one winner. And we possibly could have scored one or two more.
That third goal definitely sealed the result, didn't it?
Yeah, and it was a lovely strike by Nathan Valentine, you know. If you see that at a higher level, people will probably show it a few times because, you know, he's running towards it. He's off a bit of balance there and he's side-footed into the top corner. So, yeah, it was a great goal.
You had a good result last week, but it was important to, in a sense, put that behind you and just move on with it.
Yeah, said that before the game. It's, you know, 9-0 when it was last week. Forget that. We have to focus on what we've got to do today. Again, if you keep your shape and your discipline and do the right things, what I've always said at the right times, we can open many teams up in this league. And again, we've done it early doors and scored two good goals. So yeah, I'm pleased. More than pleased, obviously, because you know that's 12 goals in two games written on against, so it's great credit to them again.
Neville Picton came in at centre midfield, did a good job for you today.
That's never all over, to be fair. The kid's been here a long time and he's been in and out. You know, and I've just praised Nev in front of all the lads. You know, that's your commitment that you want. You know, there's a lot of times he hasn't played, the lad, to be fair to him, but he's knuckled down. He sees what we are and he loves the football club. You know, it's easy for me or him to say, well, listen, I've had enough, but the kid wants to play at AFC Liverpool. I want him here and great, great credit to him. You know, he come on against Runcorn Town and done very well and he would have played against St. Helens, only he got hurt in the Runcorn Town game, so it's a great credit. And again, you know, we've got one or two injuries, you know, and wear commitments and things like that. So it just beds well all round with the squad. But, you know, as you just said, he's done himself no harm. But when Nev does, again, the right thing at the right time, he looks a player. It's just at times he gets frustrated trying to do things and he gets me frustrated.
Build on this for Wednesday night, Winsford United.
Yeah. You know, I've told them, like, you know, because obviously one or two of my lads play on a Sunday football, not being horrible to the Sunday managers, but, you know, we're in a good position at the moment in time. We've got to keep the momentum going. So I've asked them to look after themselves over the weekend because we're in on Tuesday night prior to the game on the Wednesday. So, you know, they'll be working hard after the weekend. We look forward to Wednesday and hopefully we get the same result.
Well, congratulations on today's performance.
Thank you very much, Paul. And you think I'm going to say something funny now, don't you? But I'm not. Thank you.